In this video, we are going to solve the Power BI data modeling challenge to take any sales which are coming in on a weekend and rolling it over to a weekday. Are you ready? Now, if this is your first time on my channel, then make sure to hit subscribe and click that bell so you are notified whenever I go live to answer your Power BI questions. This Power BI challenge is presented by Pelle from Sweden, who is part of the Learn Power BI family. So Pelle asks that he has this data coming in, just kind of, you know, weekend. They're not really supposed to have any data apparently, but some data kind of trickles in. And what he would like to do is not show these onesies, twosies, and just roll it over to the next weekday. And there was a healthy discussion about this inside the group, and there were a few options discussed. So let's just walk this through, and you're gonna realize that how it might seem like a very straightforward problem, but it's worth it to consider it from the different data modeling perspectives. So let's look at the very first option, which is we can mess with the data itself. So this is the data coming in the query editor. So the first thing we can do is, and what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna add a weekday column here so we can know what's going on here. All right, so just for reference, I added the weekday here. Now what we could do is change this date column itself. So wherever it says January 6th and we detect that it's a Saturday, so wherever we detect a number coming in for a Saturday or Sunday, we could change that date to the next calendar date. Now we could do that, although I wouldn't advise to do it. Usually I stay away from changing data unless it's like a real bug which needs to be fixed. So the question to be asked is there any scenario that you would ask the model that no, I don't want to look at it where you fix the date to Monday, just show me the original date? If that scenario is there, then I would strongly recommend not changing the column itself. So instead, we're going to take the second approach and we're just going to create a reporting date column. So we have added a column reporting date and we have defined it as using the day of the week. So if the day of the week is 6 or a Saturday, then we're just gonna add 2 days to it to make it a Monday, make it the next Monday. So 1/6 gives us January 8th. And if the day of the week is 0, which is a Sunday, then we just add 1 day to it right there, and that gives us again January 8th. And of course, this is gonna apply on every single date. So now we have reporting date and the date, and let's take it back to our model. So here we have the original data as it was coming in, and you can see that we had, you know, trickling of data on Saturday and Sunday, and now using a reporting date, that data, the Saturday and Sunday, you can see is being rolled up. All of this is being sent to January 8th, and that gets the total, and that's happening throughout wherever you have a Saturday or Sunday. So that works, but there's a slight problem which I'm going to demonstrate. So here, imagine if we had other fields as we do right now in the data set. We have day name. Now what happens if I bring in a day name in here? Well, things get really funky. So we had fixed the date January 8th, but the day is still referring to the original date. Now, of course, you could, it may feel like you need to do a lot more work in this table itself to fix that, but the right way to do it is to have a calendar table. And if you're looking for a calendar table, I have the ultimate calendar table, and that's available on my channel. Just look for ultimate calendar download, or if you get this file, then just click on the link and that's gonna take you right to it. So pretty much the rule is that as long as you have a single date column, then you need a calendar table. And it doesn't matter if the dates are at a month granularity, right? You only have months, or even if you only have years, I would still strongly recommend getting a calendar table, and it's so easy to grab that, and I'm gonna do that right now and add it to the model. It's just a copy and paste. So now I have the calendar table pasted in, and using the ultimate calendar table, which is actually built completely inside the query editor, gives you the ultimate control so you can customize it to your exact needs and specifications. So our calendar table is loaded, and now all we're gonna do is simply connect a reporting date to the calendar date, and then we can slice and dice our data effectively using the reporting date. Now let's see what's going on here. Now these visuals were erroring out because I had also removed the day of the week, Monday and 0 to 6 that we had in the sales table, just because we don't need that anymore. Our calendar table has the weekday and week name, all of that is there. So now we have the reporting date and we are connected to the calendar table using the reporting date because that's how we would like to see our data. And now we can bring in from the calendar, we can bring in, let's say, a weekday, and it's not gonna have the weirdness that it was having earlier. So it's just saying Monday. And of course, in the other scenario, you might even run into trouble, for example, where the month boundary falls across a Saturday and Sunday, where let's say March 30th is a weekend, but then you add days to it, and that's gonna fall in April. And there's going to be a weirdness there. Now, of course, the big question here is that what do you do when you sometimes want to look at data as it was coming in using the original date? Now, there are two ways to solve this. One is using DAX, and I'm going to show that to you really quickly. The other way is called, I think it's called role-playing dimension. That's a fancy name. But essentially, you get a copy of the calendar table, and you say this calendar is the reporting date calendar, and the other calendar is using the transaction date, let's say. So the way we're gonna solve it though is reporting date is already connected to the calendar table. We're gonna connect this date column to the calendar table as well. Now you notice that it's a dotted line and it kind of tried to auto detect. It shouldn't be a bi-directional relationship. I'm just gonna make it a single direction. One too many. Many do one. So many on the sales side, one on the calendar side. It's always a little weird. So great, but the key thing is that it's a dotted line. Now, dotted line really means that a relationship isn't active. It didn't really do anything. Nothing changed. The data is still showing the same way. But now we can go back and create a measure which shows us total sales by the transaction date. Let's do that. So I made a few changes here. For one, I changed the date column here to say transaction date, just to have it really clear. And then we defined a new measure here, total sales by transaction date. So this is what I was talking about, that all this new measure is going to do is going to activate this relationship. And that's really, really easy to do. I'll show you the measure. All it's doing is using calculate, the magic wand of DAX, and say, yep, calculate total sales, but this time activate this relationship based on the transaction date, not the default, which is active, which is by reporting date, right? So default, if you just say total sales, which is the sum of sales amount, then we're essentially getting reporting date over here. But now over on this side, we have total sales by transaction date. So you can see things both ways. You can see, yep, this is how we want to report our numbers. But let's say you're debugging exactly trying to find a transaction and you just want to see it by the true transaction date that it came in, then you have that version of the truth as well. Now, of course, it's apparent I was talking about the month boundary, and you can see that here in March because these totals are different. So obviously, by day, if you look at January, and over here, we could see that January 8th is getting 501 from here. So that we saw earlier, but if you would go back to March, let's do that. Now, you see that March, even at the month level, total is different because the month end is falling on the weekend, and let's see what's going on over there. So if you drill down into March on both sides, again, the left one is transaction date, the right one is the reporting date, and in the left, what happened was it is the true picture. This is how the data came in, and there was March 31, which is actually a Saturday, there were two units there. But what are we gonna do for reporting date? We're gonna push it forward to April 2nd. But yeah, essentially it's gonna roll off of March. So when we're looking at by the reporting date, it is not gonna be there. And that's why the total is off by 2. So we started off with a seemingly simple question that, hey, I just don't wanna see this data on a weekend, I just want it to be added to the next date. But really what we have ended up is what's very common in financial reporting, where there is a reporting period and there's an actual transaction period, and that's often different. So now you have the solution for that. Hey, keep watching more videos and keep learning Power BI. But if you did enjoy this video, I would love to hear from you. So leave a comment, like, subscribe, all the good stuff. Power on, my friends.